while the rest of the college students in India stay in hostels situated within the college campus itself. The scene is a little different in a small suburb in Bangalore, Yelahanka. Yelahanka is home to a variety of different colleges, one of which the majority of student population belongs to Srishti Manipal Institute of Art, Design and Technology. Instead of having a borrowed campus for the college, Srishti decided to keep his campus open and spread throughout Yelahanka New Town, with students staying in various PGs scattered across the small town. The most interesting part about this system is how various PGs and colleges come together as a community to ensure a healthy and comfortable stay for the students, which is what made me curious enough to learn some more about the whole PG culture prevalent in Yelahanka. I consequently met up and had interesting conversations with the owners of the three most prominent PGs, Anita PG, Umesh PG and Sandhya PG.
Actually, I started my PG 11 years back, 2010 I started. And why I started this PG is that when I constructed my own building, I didn't want to rent out the building to anyone. So then I thought I will do the PG. And plus, I wanted to do it because my kids were also like young that time. So I was very comfortable interacting with the children. So that is the reason I thought I will start a PG. So that I can do the maintenance, all this I can take care, it's a home business, I can do it. And why I chose Srishti PG is that time Srishti was giving holidays like in the time May, June like that. So that time my kids were in the school, so their holiday was also that. So I preferred Srishti PG than any other engineering college in India because their holidays like comes September, October like that. So that time my children will not have holiday. So I wanted to match their holiday, so I chose
Srishti. See, basically when we were a long time, 23, 21, 22 years back, Yelahanka was not well developed. Students had a lot of problem about the foods. And I had approached Aditi International, not just Srishti, Aditi for some other purpose. And I was told that there may be a food requirement for teachers, not for students. So that time I started supplying food for the teachers. There were nearly 60 Aditi teachers I was giving food. That time they also asked us to do for the 60. But very few students were there at those days. And hardly 4 or 5 had registered for the food. So it started like that. Then even the college also asked me whether I can provide them space, accommodation. So that I took up. I was the first person to get into this. And all the PGs, we were the first to go. So from then onwards, it started. The next year, like first year, I had only 4 students. Then the next year, we had 20, more than 20. It went on like that.
Oh, it's just pure accident. Okay. It just so happened to start. Yeah, I mean, it wasn't a planned initiative. It so happened to start, and I think that we were good at what we did. Taking care of children, we were good at. And we have grown with
Srishti.
You always
catered
exclusively to
Srishti and the growth. Once when we started doing for the Srishti, it has always a fixed pattern. Now recently like it is changed, or otherwise like for a long time it was like that. When the children will be coming for the written after the written test for the interview, they used to come here. So the college will tell us that it's maybe for 4 days, 5 days. Initially it was like 2 days, and then after that the days were increasing, 4 days, 5 days, 6 days. So the college will inform us these are the days the parents, the students will be coming for their portfolio review to the college. So that time they will be bringing in the bus. They used to bring them to visit the PGs. They used to come here. And then they were seeing like the buildings, like the facilities and all. So that was in the month of, first week of May it happens. and then so that time we should be here to show them the places. Then after that, the result will come, and then once when the result comes, like they'll keep calling for the booking. So that time we will be busy on the phone calls like that, and sometimes they will come to see again, like personally they want to see how the PG looks, well, like the facilities and all. So they used to come. So that time the pattern of a business is that like we have to like we will be doing the thorough cleaning of all the buildings and all, and then we will be showing them for the next year's business. So that May, June, and from the July, like the students will start coming. So the July month again, all the parents will be coming here with their children to keep them open. The first time they are coming, most of them are first time coming out of the house. The parents will have so many questions and how they will to understand like how a PG operates, even simple like the washing clothes, how it will be, all these questions will be there. We have to make them settle. It will take July month and then August also. By the time then the children will be okay. They will get their friends and they will be used to our system. Then it's okay, then it goes smooth.
See, basically, if you see from morning it starts. See, our breakfast starts, so our kitchen has to start. So it starts from that point. So, and the night watchman and the night duty securities, their reporting is there. So morning they have to report me about whatever the night status was. That is one thing. Then early morning around 5:30 it starts, 5:30 to 6 it starts. So after the reporting and all, then food, where the kitchen starts. Then we have to monitor that it goes in time. Because it is given to all the buildings, so it has to reach there in time. So basically that is only monitoring part.
So. Okay, yeah, then nothing that can be done. You take care of all the children, yeah. All creative children. You are not going to have one day which is anything remotely similar to the other. There are certain basic things that have to be in place, like office begins at 9 o'clock, office ends at 6 o'clock. Okay, there is a lunch break which team discipline we take between 1 and 2, no matter what. Okay, but that's pretty much it. Everything else in between depends on, is dictated by the student's needs. Yeah, by whatever action will be. And office begins at like 9, but the day begins at pretty much 5 in the morning.
Now we have reduced the number of buildings. So now we have 10 or 12 buildings.
Why did you reduce it?
Because of this corona, the last year we were having around 22 buildings, 10 buildings. We reduced it because we don't want to do it. Because of the corona, we can't manage the small buildings. Like, yeah. Lot of care we have to. So we have reduced it.
Seven buildings. And now I had 25 houses, but now I have 12 left with me.
We have close to, I think, about 63 individual buildings.
More than 10 years back, we bought that land. And now we are developing it, and we wanted to do the farming, organic farming, sustainable living, and vegan lifestyle we want to introduce to the urban population. So we are starting the day tourism over there with all.
No, this takes all the time, right? If we are doing other businesses, like many other businesses, we won't be able to do this with heart. And if we are not doing this with heart, the children are never going to feel like this day.
It was always amazing relationship, and the Dean, like the Veda Narayan, like she was so good. Like normally, like we have seen the PGs even here in Ellaganga with the other colleges, and I know this like some of my friends, like they are doing PG in other places. They don't know like the owner or the college main authority, like they will be taking some kind of commission, and then they will see the accommodation is also part of their income. But this college, like no one was in that way, they will give us the complete freedom to do our work, and they will always monitor us. Like this is the standard they wanted. They will always monitor us, like how to, like we have to do it or how we are doing. They'll monitor. Otherwise, they have given us the full freedom to do it.
No, we have meetings. Yearly meetings are there. And in between, we have communication with the wellness team. We have communication in case needed with others as well. But if administration or other things are there. But more, mainly wellness team. They are in contact with us all the time, most of the time.
Our communications about me at least is fantastic. Both ways.
Okay, so you made me aware of the wellness thing.
Yeah. So especially during a time like this, we are in touch with the wellness team almost on a daily basis. We are in constant touch with the dean of students, all for the children's welfare. So whatever the child needs. Be it corona care, okay, or be it any other kind of support that they need. So we have been in, the communication has been amazing involving us. And it's been like that from the beginning. So whatever is required is very, so there is no talking in, there is no talking obliquely, not talking to the point. Whatever is required is spoken very openly. Between each other, and it's always been like that. If they require something from us, if they think we fall short somewhere, and likewise, if we feel that we need something to be done, and it's been always frank discussions. And the one thing that has been a common trend in all the discussions is student welfare. So anything that is discussed is discussed in student welfare.
It's really, it was too tough for us. All these years, like we have started this business, I have started so many years back with 14 students. And it was like our passion. We were doing it from heart, we were doing everything. And in this business, like you see the one building, now this is my own building, but most of that's our rented building. So many rented buildings. So the rented building, for taking the building, for taking the building, we have to give them in advance. Suppose like if we are giving 20 lakhs to the advance for that building, we will be collecting from the students maximum 16 lakhs or 18 lakhs. Balance money we are putting from our pocket to take that building. Once when we take that building, we have to have a lot of investment in that. But all of a sudden when the pandemic came, the children, they have told that they are going, they wanted to vacate because everyone was confused and so many of them, like their business affected, their work affected. So they wanted to save their money, they have taken it. But they told that our contract is always from July to June. So after the last June, like they said, they don't want to continue. They will just see like when the college is opening, they'll come. So the building owners, like even they also taken huge loan and then constructed the building. Initially it was all confusion. Then after that we came to a conclusion that the children also, some of the students, like they have given us percentage of money they were paying, and the building owners also given us some concession, and then we were able to move forward.
Initially nobody knew that it would be this kind of magnitude. So when it started and people suddenly stopped paying also immediately from March to April, they stopped paying. But the owners, they were not understanding because we had a yearly this thing contract, so they wanted the same amount. I paid also till that agreement was over. After that, then we had to negotiate. By that time, 3 months over, March, April, May, June. Then they were also seeing how the situation is and started understanding. That time, some understanding became with the owners. Whoever could not adjust, we have given away the houses. Whoever could adjust, some understanding, we could go forward. But even with that understanding, it was a great loss. Great loss.
I'm not going to state the office, okay? Because you know how it's affected. I know how it's affected us, and I think everyone knows how it's affected. That's the boring part that people are repeating again and again. We were as badly affected in the same magnitude as every month, okay? What I would like to talk about, the effects of the pandemic, so to speak, what I would like to talk about is, because of the pandemic, the kind of communication that's been there between us, like I was saying, and the wellness team, between us and Mrs. Kanan, and vice versa, between Mrs. Kanan and us, and between the wellness team and us, for student welfare. The kind of communication that has been happening between us and the student body itself, never has there been such good, transparent, respectful communication between the student body and us. Okay, it used to happen when we were a very small number, when we were 40 people, 60 people, even up to 75 people. Once it started getting bigger, it became difficult to communicate personally with everyone. But now that is happening again, which is amazing. The communication between us and the parent body, it's been absolutely amazing. So communication has been fantastic. The empathy between all the parties involved has been quite a revelation, actually. You know, the empathy that people have, the understanding that people have, the compassion that people have, even student for student. Okay, the way I'm seeing amazing adjustments being made by kids. One child has to quarantine in one room. The roommate will move out without being asked to. Okay? And that roommate doesn't have to live in the living room. The roommate is immediately absorbed into another room by other children. Okay? Because everyone seems to be in this together. And that is absolutely amazing. So this is a positive reaction to the pandemic and its situation. And I don't think anyone's talking about this. But it's quite a treat to watch, honestly. It's quite a treat to watch. And this is happening constantly on an everyday basis. So it's like every day you go back with, like, oh shit, we're screwed. And at the same time, you're like, wow, what's happening is so nice.
Initially, like, no one was copying each other, but I'm the person, like, I have taken initiative. And we have very good relation now. We have a group also in that. We also have our own common problems. We discuss, we all go through the same way. Very good relation.
It's cordial.
Yes.
Well,
we have cordial relationships. We have very
cordial
relationships. Every building we have multi-storied building. That's one point, like we can control it. So the person will be there, the caretaker, normally the building, so we have a caretaker there. So we are the responsibility, they take the responsibility for all the building. Now that, the whole building, they'll take it. So, and then we have CCTV cameras, so we have very reliable workers that you also must have experienced by now.
See, there are my process is that each security, each building is properly informed and I have to each building. I don't have one person doing both the job, twice the thing. They do two person, one building and only security job, mostly, so majority that. Secondly, I follow the camera. Any incidences, I re-question anybody going out, coming in late night or anything. So, I depend on camera as well. Camera, security and feedback, that is how. Student feedbacks also we get. So, both ways we take care.
Communication, okay? Constant proper communication with the student body and with the parent body and with the school, okay? That is one thing. Communication between each other has really helped. Identifying primary contacts, if any, identifying a child who is ill, okay? And taking care of them, all that is because of communication. So the number one thing we have been very, very aware of and very particular about is the right communication we have to have. And then of course, there is a very, like none of this would be possible, taking care of children on this magnitude would not be possible without my staff. Okay, my staff, since the lockdown last year, has been waking up at 3:30 in the morning. My kitchen staff wakes up at 3:30 in the morning. They still wake up, like when you all had offline classes, my kitchen staff used to come in at 4 in the morning so that the children had, like, you know, a separate breakfast and a separate lunch. Like, You know, they were different. They were not just breakfast packed for lunch also. So the staff's hard work has certainly made like everything better. And you know, like what my housekeeping team does, sanitization of houses where there are possible infections, how well they actually clean surfaces, all of that. That's made a big difference. We have protocols for laundry. We have protocols for absolutely every department. Every department has their particular COVID protocols. So, and of course, the management diligently follows up and makes sure that, you know, there are little or no lapses. And if there is a lapse, then plug it immediately. Don't let it get out of hand, basically.
That's it. Thank you so much.
Yeah, that is it.
Yes, sir.
That's all.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, future is actually really good. Like, I actually.